climate change is a growing issue and becoming a global concern. Our actions as a species and the way we live in our modern world is arguably driving up the world's temperature and enacting what is referred to as climate change. What is climate change? A changing climate is normal and natural. Natural processes cause the Earth's climate to change. However, in the modern day, the change in climate and global temperatures is rising at an unnatural rate. So, although climate change has always been a thing, the term climate change has become a contemporary phrase referring to the unnatural and human-caused change in climate. So what causes this climate change? To put it simply, it's this. That's carbon. It is essential to all life on Earth. However, carbon itself is not dangerous. It's actually very natural and makes up all living things on Earth. Carbon is propelled around the Earth in a cycle. This cycle starts with plants, who absorb the carbon from the atmosphere, turning it into oxygen. But eventually these plants die, and they are consumed by animals and microorganisms. These creatures, including humans, then emit carbon back out into the atmosphere through breathing and excretion. However, they all eventually die too, and end up back in the ground, trapping that carbon underground in the form of fossil fuels and rock. Similarly, the ocean also has plants which consume carbon, and the oceans absorb carbon from the atmosphere. Also, rain washes carbon back into the ocean. The carbon from dead creatures that is trapped and is sometimes released through volcanic eruptions, which starts the whole cycle over again. However, humans mess this up with their factories, construction, and housing. They take carbon from under the ground and release it prematurely to fuel such projects. Because so much carbon in such little time is being put back into the atmosphere, it begins to have grave effects. Heat that would normally leave the Earth was being trapped and causing temperatures to rise massively. But why is this so bad? Climate has dangerous effects on the Earth. It causes changes in rainfall, sea level rise, droughts, heat waves, and extreme weather, all which can lead to flooding and other disastrous events. But some people question this and don't believe climate change is real or a concern.
Part of what's unique about climate change, though, is the nature of some of the opposition to action. It's pretty rare that you'll encounter somebody who says the problem you're trying to solve simply doesn't exist. When President Kennedy set us on a course for the moon, there were a number of people who made a serious case that it wouldn't be worth it. It was going to be too expensive, it was going to be too hard, it would take too long. But nobody ignored the science. I don't remember anybody saying that the moon wasn't there or that it was made of cheese. Today's Congress, though, is full of folks who stubbornly and automatically reject the scientific evidence about climate change. They will tell you it is a hoax or a fad. One member of Congress actually says the world is cooling. There was one member of Congress who mentioned a theory involving dinosaur flatulence, which I won't get into, but their view may be wrong and a fairly serious threat to everybody's future, but at least they have the brass to say what they actually think. There's some who also duck the question. They say, when they're asked about climate change, they say, hey, look, I'm not a scientist. And I'll translate that for you. What that really means is, I know that man-made climate change really is happening, but if I admit it, I'll be run out of town by a radical fringe that thinks climate science is a liberal plot, so I'm not going to admit it.
I don't want to give trillions and trillions of dollars. I don't want to lose millions and millions of jobs. I don't want to be put at a disadvantage.
I wish you could go to Greenland, watch these huge chunks of ice just falling into the ocean, raising the sea levels.
And you don't know whether or not that would have happened with or without man. You don't know.
Well, you're scientists at NOAA and NASA.
We have scientists that disagree with that.
You know, I was thinking, what if he said, no, I've seen the hurricane situations, I've changed my mind, there really is climate change. And I thought, wow, what an impact. What an impact that would make.
I'm not denying climate change, but it could very well go back. You know, we're talking about over millions of years. They say that we had hurricanes that were far worse than what we just had with Michael.
Who says that? They say.
You mean the people on the phone? People say that in the...
Yeah, but what about the scientists who say it's worse than ever?
You'd have to show me the scientists, because they have a very big political agenda, Leslie.
I can't bring them in.
Scientists also have a political...
That is US President Donald Trump talking about how he is skeptical of climate change and wants some hard proof. He raised the point that we don't know if man caused this. Do we know? And if so, where is that evidence? The main evidence can be seen by carbon levels in the atmosphere. This graph shows how rapidly carbon levels have risen since just 1950. Evidence can also be found in things like tree rings, ocean sediments, coral reefs, and layers of sedimentary rock. This ancient evidence reveals that current warming is occurring roughly 10 times faster than the average rate of ice age recovery warming. So if all this can be found, how can someone like Trump arguing it isn't happening?
I just don't think climate change is real.
Is there anything a scientist can say to you to change your mind or show you?